This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
Broadcasting live from the Civic Media Studios in Green Bay, this is Nite Lite with Pete Schwaba, your inside source on everything entertainment from Wisconsin to Hollywood. And now, a guy who writes checks his mouth can't cash, Pete Schwaba.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to hour number two of Nite Lite. Great to have you with me on this Thursday night, the Thursday before the biggest Thursday of the year. We're counting down the days here till Thanksgiving. Our question of the night is, what Guinness Book of World Record do you think you'd have a shot at? Given your talents, it is National Guinness Book of World Records Day. What record do you think is within reach? What do you think you could do, given your talents? Conrad says, what did you say?
Curb scratches on my tire.
Yeah, that's pretty specific. I say procrastinating. I know those aren't technically Guinness Book of World Records. Let's find out what our next, what our guests say. We have new guests in the studio. These guys are from Comedy City in De Pere. I'm thrilled to have them here. It's Nick Wallen, Scott Rumott, and Nick Hendel. Mm-hmm. All right. Guys, welcome.
Hello.
Hi. Hi.
Actually missed a syllable on my name.
I did?
It's Wallander.
Oh, Wallander.
It happens all the time.
You know what? I'm going to blame Conrad. He just started here, and that's a merit point.
Yeah, I just started about a year and a half ago.
I'm sorry about that, Nick. So I think I saw Wallander, but I almost thought I was thinking the TV show Young Wallander. I'm like, yeah. No, it's Wallen. But I was wrong after all. All right, Nick Wallander. Well, it's great to have you guys here. Regardless of names, it's great to have you guys here. So do you guys have something you think you could – would be within reach Guinness Book of World Record wise? Could you improv something?
Yeah, I could probably definitely drop as much items as possible. I'm really good at dropping things. I knock things over. I have my cat that takes after me. He knocks things over all the time. I could just easily just drop anything.
Make a little money off your cat, that sounds like.
Yeah.
What about you guys?
Yeah, well, Nick and I recently actually participated in something that is involved in the world. A Guinness Book of World Records.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, I love it.
The world's largest ball of paint.
Ball of paint? How does that work?
Well, this guy in Indianapolis, I think it's like 37 years ago, he had a baseball. He painted it, and then he painted it again and again. His son got involved. They decided to make the ball grow as big as they possibly could, and eventually he got the attention of the Guinness Book of World Records, and he lets people just come visit him and paint the ball.
Oh, my gosh. So where is your tie-in with that?
Oh, guys? We were going to a festival in Tennessee, Oak Ridge, Tennessee, and we decided we were going to drive and stop at a few places along the way. And we picked that as one of the locations to stop at. We showed up and painted the ball of paint, which was over 10,000 pounds in weight at that point
what?
In time.
What?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So for a moment, for about 2 hours, we were the ones who... got them to the world record because it's progressively getting bigger. It's still the world record winning paintball.
This is like karma, I think. Just the fact that we're doing this question tonight and you guys are part of a record. So how big is the ball now?
It's huge. I mean, it's as big as... I mean,
use your hands on the radio.
Yeah. Yeah. It's wider than a car, I would say.
Yes, yeah.
And they just keep it the same spot because it's too heavy to move, I would assume?
Yeah.
Can you roll it?
You could, but it's actually on a harness type thing that was sponsored and paid for by Sherwin-Williams, if I'm correct. I guess they paid for the rig on it. He's got like a digital scale above it that tells you how much it weighs. And then he writes like the number of layers on the ball right before you paint it. So we were at like 29,000 and some change was the layer number that we did.
You could pick the gloss or flat paint or like
you could pick the color.
You could pick the color.
So we picked green for Green Bay.
Yeah. And weirdly enough, the Indianapolis Star was there snapping pictures for a story that day. So,
That was a great trip.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's some pictures out there if any of you want to go look it up. It's pretty insane.
I believe you. I don't think we need proof. I think it's So this is fun. All right, you guys are part of Comedy City. Tell us a little bit about what Comedy City is and what you guys do.
All right, Comedy City is an improv comedy theater where we take suggestions from the audience and incorporate them into various improv games, little scenes. And depending on the show, sometimes it's a longer scene. So basically, it's an interactive environment where the audience gives us suggestions, and then we create the story on the spot, or we use it in a song or a little gimmicky game that improv people have been doing for years. So basically, it's just something that didn't exist before the audience came in, and they get to be a big part of creating it.
It's really interesting, Nick. When you and I were emailing, you said you might want to ask me what improv is, because a lot of people might not technically know. Like, you hear, like, when I was a stand-up, I worked at the Improv. People might think it's a building or a whatever, but it is a form. It's an art form. So tell people that might not know, that are listening, exactly what improv is.
All right. So as I described earlier, improv is creating some sort of performance on the spot. And it's usually using suggestions, whether it's from the audience or some other means. Nothing is pre-planned. And the other big part about it is that it's usually team-oriented. You're almost always going to have two or more people working together.
Okay.
And they use a core concept called yes and in improv, which means when something is presented to you, you accept it and you build upon it. You make it better. You add to it. And essentially that's what has been the base of improv for like well over like a century plus, I think, since it's taken hold in America. Yes and is the core concept, and beautiful things get created that nobody knew could exist because everyone decided to accept each other's ideas and take it wherever it went.
And that's the beauty of it. And I love, like, so if you're on stage like with Scott and Scott says, hey, you bought a store, you'd say yes. And
yes,
because if you say no, the scene's done.
Yeah, the scene's done. Yeah, and it's counterintuitive because a lot of people think that entertainment, or if you're watching a movie, every scene is based on conflict and people should disagree. Well, conflict isn't always disagreeing, and conflict doesn't have to be between two people. The conflict can come from external sources. So the fun is finding that game within the game. Like, all right, we're on this journey together, but like, what are we working on together? What are we going to? What problem are we going to solve together? And sometimes there's conflict that comes into play, but it's all still based in yes and. You're agreeing that that conflict is legitimate and then adding to the ridiculousness of it.
Yeah, that's so great. And I noticed, if you can hold your arm up for the stream, I saw the tattoo, yes and. Mm-hmm. This is how serious these guys take their craft. That's so cool.
Yeah, it's a good note, so I don't forget.
Just so, in the middle of the scene. All right, so tell us a little more about Comedy City. Where are you guys? I think I heard that you've been around almost 40 years.
Yeah.
How did it get started? Give us a little bit of the background, if you
right
would.
Right near here, actually.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. history goes back a little farther. So right now we're in downtown De Pere. We'll get to that later. So Comedy City as an entity started back in 1987, and it was a franchise of Comedy Sports, which is a national chain of improv theaters, which, yes, there's even chains of improv theaters. Milwaukee actually has one still. Yeah. So we started out in Oshkosh, from what I understand, for about a year, and then they moved closer to Green Bay and ran as a Comedy Sports franchise until about 1999, and then they converted over to Comedy City. They kept some of the same concepts and ideas of team versus team improv.
Okay.
So that's what Comedy Sports is. You had a red team and a blue team, a referee. And it's sort of like Whose Line Is It Anyway, but more structured. The points actually mattered to an extent. Somebody did win or lose. The franchise, I'm sure there was a business decision behind leaving the franchise, but same core concept. It became Comedy City. And then I think about year 2000, Mike Esserkan, the current owner of the Troupe, did take over it. So he's been running that since about 2000. And then we've been Comedy City, and then we've gradually changed our format a little bit. We still play a lot of the same smaller short form improv games, but we are less competitive with how we do it.
Okay.
That's more or less the history, and we've bounced around. One of our early locations as Comedy City was downtown. Scott, you know more about that.
Yeah, the subway right there.
The Subway. The sub shop?
Subway sandwich, yeah.
And Washington Street. Yeah, yeah. This is Washington Street.
Yeah. This is, it's like a block away. But there's also one, when I used to watch improv when I was a kid, back when I was comedy sports. We'd come in and, you know, middle school, and we'd see them doing their shows. And it was right, I'm not even sure downtown anymore, but it was a bar like just a few blocks away.
Oh.
21 Steps, I think it was called. It was right near there. And then they moved to where the Subway is now. And then we moved to DePere.
Yeah, DePere was probably almost 20 years ago, I would imagine.
Probably, yeah. So do you guys only do improv, or do you write sketches too, or is it all pure improv?
Well, the thing about improv is it attracts a wide array of people with various talents. So some of our people do venture into things like writing plays. Like Mike Esterkhan, for example, has written many plays and produced them. So he's written books as well. And then there are other people that have tried stand-up. John Egan, a member of our troupe, is a stand-up in the area. He does a lot of shows in Northeast Wisconsin and around the region as well. So we do occasionally do a little sketch work. Not as much as we used to. We do regular sketch shows back in the day. But yeah, we can dabble in it. And in fact, this weekend, there is a special show at the club in conjunction with the Green Bay Fringe Festival. It's a fundraiser for them. It's called a 24-hour theater festival. So on Friday night at about 6 o'clock, the people who agreed to participate will gather at the theater, and then they'll split up into teams. They will have a writer, a director, and people acting. And the writers are going to get a prompt. And they're going to have 24 hours to write a script, about 5 to 10 minutes worth of content, and then bring that in the morning. They rehearse it. They basically learn the sketches and the skits, and they perform it on stage 6:30 Saturday night. So,
how fun.
Yeah, so stuff like that happens. We don't do just improv there, so we take advantage of opportunities like that to try fun different things when we get a chance to.
You got
to
keep it interesting for you guys too, because even, I mean, improv, when you've done it enough, I'm sure you look for ways to make it, you know, and so you don't fall into those same, you know, whatever it is your responses are. You have to keep it interesting too, right? So that sounds like a great way to.
Yeah, there's definitely a hill that you're always constantly climbing and trying to be more and do more things.
That's awesome. Okay, so Scott Rumott, got it right. Nick Hendel.
Yep.
And Nick Wallander, not Wallen, are here in the studio from Comedy City in DePere. When we come back, can we get a little sample of some improv? Maybe?
Absolutely.
Yeah, all right, fantastic.
Yes, and.
You guys are going to perform. Nicely done. The guys are going to perform, and we will. This is a very short break, so they're going to stretch out and get ready, and then we will have live improv here tonight in the Nite Lite Studios. This is Pete Schwaba on the Civic Media Radio Network. They watch us from the corner of their eye, but there ain't no doubt, early down here, we're gonna change what the heck got. When I'm out on the street, I walk the way I wanna walk.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
Welcome back. Listening or watching on the stream. Craig Knitt, who seems to know everybody in Green Bay, says, hey, Nick's and Scott.
Yeah.
Nick's plural.
Oh, Craig.
Craig's been part of the troupe for a while.
Oh, has he? Okay.
Yeah, he doesn't perform anymore, so we can scold him for being too busy.
Well, how are you part of the troupe if you don't perform?
Oh, it's
that's
Craig.
A good question.
You just boss people around or what?
Right. Yeah, Craig.
He says your suggestion. Okay, we'll get to that. I'll give a suggestion from Craig. Folks, if you want to, let's listen to what these guys do and set it up. And then if you want to chime in with a suggestion for what you guys want these to do, let me know, and we will we'll give your feed your suggestion to the pros here. So tell us a little bit about what this game is and what you need from us.
All right. Well, we figured since we were going to be on the radio in front of microphones that we would do a little game that's known as Newscaster.
Okay.
So we're going to do a little fake newscast here, and it's going to be based on probably something we get from either you or Conrad here. And then we're just going to riff a newscast and have that be the breaking news
All right. I love it. This is Nick Wallander, Nick Hendel, and Scott Rumat here from Comedy City in De Pere. Conrad, do you have a suggestion?
But that's actually, I'll give you a prompt. Okay.
Okay.
Have you encountered something that's inconvenienced you recently and you're like, oh man, why did that just happen?
I think this goes for both of us. A really slow driver.
Yes.
Ooh. All right. Let's hear a little bit. We're going to get a little bit of information. All right. Where did this happen most recently?
Highway 41.
Highway 41. Going to Green Bay?
Heading to Green Bay around Okano. Heading to Green Bay. Someone pulled out right in front of me and went like 30 miles. I almost rear-ended him.
Oh.
Yeah.
And what city were you near when it happened?
Okano.
Oh, Okano. Yeah. Of course, you just said that. And
it's incorporated.
What kind of vehicle is it?
It was a pickup truck, and like maybe 20 years old, 2005-ish.
All right.
Yeah.
I think we can work with that.
Yeah.
All right.
Is that worthy of breaking news?
Oh, that's the fun
of
improv.
Always.
Yeah. If it was too interesting, it wouldn't be fun to work with. That's what we like to say. All right. Here we go. All right. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to downtown Green Bay at WGBW. This is Comedy City News Night. My name is Chuck Chuckles, and I am your news anchor this evening. Before we get into the breaking news that just came in, we need to remind you that this weekend weather looks like it's going to be great. We'll get a forecast in a moment from our chief meteorologist on that, and the Packers play on Sunday. All right, breaking news just came in. There is an extremely slow driver southbound heading towards Green Bay just outside of Oconto. He is driving a pickup truck, and there is a line of traffic behind them. It has been the talk of Twitter, Facebook, and my great aunt's church group. All right. Actually, we do have somebody on the scene in a Honda Accord. He's our chief news correspondent out on the road. Let's hear from our chief news correspondent.
Hey, Chuck, it's me, Steve. We're just over here on Highway 41. I noticed a car was driving a little slow, so I decided to just do a little jog next to him and try to interview the driver. Excuse me. Steve, WGBW, Comedy City News. Why are you going so slow? The sign clearly says 70 miles per hour.
Well, I'm going to the diner. You know, I gotta eat. I gotta eat. At that church service, I just I don't want to be rushed. You know, I'm in this day of this age that I can't be rushed.
I'm sorry. What's your name, sir?
Oh, my name's Tim.
Tim is a lazy driver because he's going to Disney. Not Disney, dinner. What? Do you like Disney dinner?
Yes.
Hey, can we find out what is so great about this dinner he's heading to?
Yeah, where are you going?
Well, they have a senior special, 65 plus, $5 for 3 eggs, 2 bacon, 1 toast, and coffee.
That's actually a pretty good idea.
That's a pretty good deal.
$5? Where is this at?
It's at the Nancy's Diner. She serves it up hot.
Well, I should hope so, because if they had cold coffee and cold eggs, that's not even worth $5 to me, and I eat eggs every day. Anyways, back to you in the studio. I'll get more information on this diner, and I'll come back to you after I have some bacons.
All right. Thank you very much. All right, so let's move right on over to the sports news for the day. We already know that we have the Packers playing this weekend, but we're also told that just outside of Oconto, there's some other interesting sports going on. So I'm going to throw it over to Jim Ringo, our sports broadcaster.
Thanks you very much. You know, as a big sports guy myself, Packers are obviously in the forefront of my frontal lobe and my thinking. You know, I want to express that I can't wait to see them play the other opposition team that they're going to play today, tomorrow, Sunday? Sunday.
Yes, on Sunday.
Sunday. You're going to play Sunday. But as you were saying, there's other teams that are playing this weekend, too. We got the Beavers, local hockey team, ladies hockey team. Go Beavers. We got the Mole Rats, a baseball team that doesn't know that it's not baseball season anymore, right? It's not baseball season anymore?
All right. You know what? That's enough for sports this evening. We'll have a conversation with you after the broadcast. However, we did just get word there's been a development on Highway 41, so we're going to throw it back out to the road right now.
Hey, it's Chuck. Thanks, Chuck. It's Steve again. So it turns out our little advertisement for the diner is causing more people to drive 30 miles an hour on the highway. You, sir, and the... Excuse me, you. I'm not going to... You rolled on the window. Where are you going?
Oh, me? I'm going to the diner.
Hey, what's your name, sir?
My name's Craig. I'm really excited for this diner. I heard it's pretty good. I heard on the news, he said that's $5 for three eggs, two bacon, one toast, and a cup of coffee, too.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a pretty good deal, you know. I like to save a few bucks where I'm from, you know.
Steve, can you ask, is that Craig Knitt?
Yeah, he's got a license plate that's hand-drawn. Yeah, but it's definitely Craig.
I bet he's trying to film a movie while he's doing this.
I am.
Oh. All right. Well, thank you for that report from the road. We're actually going to switch on over a few gears, and let's hear about the weather.
Can we pause weather? That's great. We got to do a quick thing. We got to do news. The guys from Comedy City are here. The Tunics and Scott, and they just did a great newscast. I hope we can pick up with weather when we come back.
Oh, we'll move on to something else.
Or whatever you guys want to do.
We'll go to the real news.
All right, we're hanging out here in the studio with Comedy City, and Civic Media's award-winning news is next, and we'll be back with more improv live here at Nite Lite with Pete Schwaba on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
All right, we're back here at the Nite Lite Studios here at WGBW, and it's great to have the guys from Comedy City here. Nick Wallander, Scott Rumott, and Nick Hendel are here tonight. They did some improv for us right before the news. Guys, first of all, do you have any holiday shows coming up? You guys get more crowded then?
Oh, yeah. Business picks up regardless at the holiday season. But recently, in the last couple of years, we decided, like, hey, let's create a couple of holiday themed shows. So we have quite a bit of stuff coming up. It's crazy the number of shows that we have. And it starts next week, technically, the night before Thanksgiving, Wednesday night. We don't ever do shows on Wednesdays. We tried it last year, and people are looking for stuff to do rather than hang out with their in-laws or talk to their high school friends at a bar. That's the start of it next Wednesday night. And then next weekend, we start one of four shows called Snowy Mittens, an improvised holiday romance. It's an improvised take on Hallmark Christmas movies.
I love it.
Yeah, it writes itself as we're on stage. Like, those movies are all so similar that we get suggestions from we basically do a Mad Libs with the audience. And just fill in the blank and create a plot line and play it out. That one's been pretty popular. We have, at the theater itself, we have a couple radio plays coming up in the week right before Christmas, and it's two nights, and it's if you aren't familiar with radio plays, it's like going back to the 30s and 40s. Actors reading from scripts, and then we have a Foley station where the sound effects are created live. Last year we did A Christmas Story. This year we went a little more contemporary, and it's going to be Die Hard.
Nice.
And then later that week we have a tradition that we've done for almost 10 years now, the comedy roast of Santa Claus. Don't bring the kids. It's a riot. And then right before Christmas, we have another Snowy Mittens. We have a puppet-based show for the kids where we improvise with puppets. That's been fun. And then there's also the John Brunage Christmas special, which is one of our troop members, John Brunage. He will tell you that it's a Christmas special featuring him, John Brunage, and leave it at that. But it's more like an improvised take on like the old Dean Martin Christmas specials. And I'm sure there's something I'm forgetting in the mix as well. But check us out at comedycity.net or comedycity.fun. I like saying that version of it because you can get a .fun domain on the internet.
Oh, no kidding.
That's what we got.
That's great.
So yeah, comedycity.fun. You can see the whole lineup there or check us out on Facebook.
Who are your, like, if you have people that you kind of emulate or that inspired you as improvisers, who would they be, like Second City or Groundlings or SCTV?
Actually, it's also a local person as well. When I grew up, I watched Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Yeah.
And Joel Hodgson was from Schwabenon.
Yeah.
And I watched that and I'm addicted to that show. So like, I think a lot of the improvisation that I did when I was younger was just talking back to the TV and just seeing like how, you know, how funny I could be to myself. but then I took that, you know, to Comedy City and I was like, all right, let's do some jokes now. And I can just boom, 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 shout out things that I want to say, riffs and all that stuff.
What about you guys?
Yeah. Definitely for me, you know, when I was a child, I liked, you know, watching like Eddie Murphy and stuff. I liked Plaintive Accents, but a more local hero for me, is a guy in our troop named Garth Zimmerman, or Mr. Zimmerman to me. So in the sixth grade, he was my teacher. He was my sixth grade teacher. After school, he had this improv club that he ran for many, many years, doing games that we play now, that we, you know, we play in the troop.
Yeah.
And he was teaching kids improv, because kids and improv go really well together. Kids don't have any, they're not in any boxes, you know?
There's no filter.
There's no filter. Right. They have such creativity that they can just spew out, and teaching those skills of like working together was really good. And so Mr. Zimmerman, I can't break that.
So funny, you know, that you call another guy in your troupe Mr.
Oh yeah,
just him.
This guy like 70 or something, like
You know, he taught me everything I knew, and he actually retired my year, so he never taught any more improv. He's still in the troupe. Okay. But then when I was in high school, he asked me to join. And so that's how I started. And so for me, a lot of my improv was from him. Because before that, I had no idea what improv was. I had no basis for it. So
that's so cool. What about you, Nick?
I think I have a few different influences. And I mean, going back to being a kid, I was always in a little trouble for, you know, trying to be too funny. And eventually, you know, found a way to use it. but I think this goes all the way back to... I was a fan of pro wrestling as a kid, and there were a lot of really popular wrestlers, guys like The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Ric Flair, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Those guys rarely used a script, and they were funny as can be. So I was like, oh, that's really cool. Like, there was a point in time where I'm in like high school, and I'm like, let's do backyard wrestling, and like maybe I'll get in shape and do that one day. Didn't happen. But then, you know, you start watching a lot of comedy on TV. In college, I saw a little stand-up. There was an improv group on campus I watched a few times. At that point, I had no idea I wanted to do it. And then when I moved to Green Bay about 17 years ago, I started watching Comedy City shows. And that's where I think I really got inspired. Was like, oh, wow, there are people doing this locally. This isn't like trying to get to L.A. or Chicago or New York. You can do improv anywhere. So auditions were held. So I'd say like the people that I really like looked at and said, they're great, I'd like to do this, are people like Mike Esterkhan, who is our fearless leader, and even Craig Kindit, I'll bring up. He's one of the guys that I would see in shows all the time. And, you know, he was brilliant. My friend Jessica Blavitt was a regular performing back in the day, and she was absolutely brilliant. As well. So it was just really cool to see that you can do improv anywhere. Anyone can do it. And I gave it a shot, auditioned a couple times, and ended up in it. And now I get to be friends with those people.
You didn't say my name.
Yeah. Well, you're here. That'd be weird. You're here.
He doesn't want any of that awkwardness between.
Yeah. I'll slide you a dollar.
It's so cool that you guys, and you're right, that this group exists in Green Bay. You don't even have to go to Milwaukee. You know, it's right here. And it's such a great outlet. All right. You guys are going to do something next called Advice Column. Explain what this is to us.
All right. So we're going to get some general suggestions, each of us, that is going to inform the type of character we're going to play.
Okay.
And then at that point, once we get that suggestion, we'll introduce ourselves, and then we'll get ready to field questions from either you, Conrad, or anyone in the audience who might have one on the text, Facebook, wherever.
If people want to text in a suggestion, what kind of stuff do you recommend they text in?
Not like yes or no type questions. Open-ended. Like
anything they're looking for advice
yeah,
from.
Yeah, like what should I do?
Actual advice.
Yeah, what should I do about my boss who's overbearing? Or, you know, my dog keeps digging holes.
Okay, that's all right, folks. If you want to get part of the fun here, text in a suggestion for these guys. This is advice column, and you can get actual advice for a problem you're having. So let us know. You can call or text. What do you need from us to get started?
We'll each ask a question first, and then we'll get our character set.
Okay.
So for my character, I'm going to base it off of a dialect or like a European dialect that you might have or a regional accent that you might have. So that's what I'm looking for my character.
So other you or Conrad, if you got one.
Give you a dialect
dialect if you could you know
is like, Northeast like, Wisconsin too easy? How about Illinois? How about Chicago?
You want Chicago?
Yeah,
I'll try that. I'll try it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, and then I'll take. How about a hobby that you might think people just spend a lot of time doing?
Bowling.
Nice.
All right.
All right, and then what? Like a group of people from like high school or college? Like, oh, it's that group of people at the table.
The Glee Club.
Glee Club. All right. All right. Well, we'll start with Nick and have him introduce himself.
Yeah, I'm a Gary. My name's Gary. I'm from Chicago, the Windy City. You know, I'm proud to be here. I'm real excited to be here. Answer your questions. Get some advice answered. Send your questions my way. You know, I'm here for it.
All right, my name's Dave. I go bowling down at the long range. I got a 297 last week, not to brag, but it's pretty hard score to get. But you know, I think I might go to the pros eventually, maybe once I take those bumpers out.
Hey everybody, my name is Trevor. I am here to dole out all the best advice. La 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 la.
All right. So it's suggestion time. Okay, Craig Kinnett says, hey guys, I've got some kids that just can't behave this close to Christmas. What advice would you have?
Well, I think a great idea would be to take all of them to the movie theater and have them see a Wicked, but take them to AMC theaters where they said they're not allowed to sing or talk and let the people at the theater take care of it.
Now, what I like to do is when my children are causing a ruckus, I just take some of the 12-pound balls and have them hold one in each hand. That way they walk around the house carrying that weight, those 24 pounds and all, and it just tuckers them out. They get all tired and sleepy. They don't even have any energy to fight back. They'll just be like, okay, I'll go to bed now.
Nah. I tell them. Zit is not coming around. He's not coming around. And I'll hand deliver the coal to him. I'll give him the coal. I'll tell him, you know, you're a bad kid. You're getting nothing but coal, and you can't even use it. We don't use coal anymore. You can't even use it.
I've got a neighbor who parks in my driveway. What should I do?
Well, what you got to do is make sure that your driveway is so dangerous for him that he cannot park his car, because as soon as he gets in out of his car, you just put a whole bunch of wax down and he'll slide and fall. Or if it gets winter time, you just spray your whole driveway down with water, it'll freeze, he'll fall, he'll think twice about parking in your driveway.
You know, I'd say me and you are friends, right? Me and you are friends. Well, I got this cousin of mine, his name's Tony. He runs his own fixer up a place. He takes away cars when they need to be taken away, you know what I mean? And you give him a call. You give Tony a call. You say Gary sent you, and he'll fix that. He'll get rid of that car for you.
Just the car?
Yeah. Okay. Just the car.
Well, I think you should challenge him to a sing-off. So you get your best friends, and he'll get his besties, and you just get stand on both sides of the driveway, and you just start singing. And if that doesn't work, you should do what they did in Hamilton and just duel it out.
If that doesn't work, maybe just a dance off or an arm wrestle or something.
Sure, whatever. But definitely some singing should be involved.
Okay. It's Nick Wallander, Scott Rumott, and Nick Hendel here doing advice column. They're from Comedy City in De Pere. Check out their shows. They have a lot of stuff going on this time of year. Can you guys hang out? We got one more quick break, and then I'd love it if you help me close down the show.
I mean, totally.
Sometimes yeah, stay in character if you want. I want to ask you about your venue when we come back and your theater and what that's like, and we'll put a bow on this thing. Thanks so much for being here tonight, guys. Scott and the Knicks will be here, and Craig hopefully will still stick with us here on the stream. This is Pete Schwaba at Nightlight. We are coming right back, and I'll read some more of your texts too.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Tomorrow night on the show, it is a bar band Friday night. Terry Barr will be here with some new music, like she is every week. And some great conversation. That's tomorrow night on Nightlight. Tonight, we have the guys from Comedy City here in De Pere, the two Knicks and Scott. If you guys ever break off, I think that could be a great sketch group name.
We have another Nick in the troupe. We have three Knicks. And so we're looking for a fourth Nick to join so we can do a Nick at Night show.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Knicker Shop Quartet, maybe. Mm-hmm. Ooh. And we'll go to the text line here, too. I want to make sure we get these in. Steady Eddie says, Pete, my world record, one word or maybe two, Haagen-Dazs. I heard Haagen-Dazs is just a made-up word or two. I believe I could eat more Haagen-Dazs coffee ice cream in 1 hour than any other human being now alive. It's very specific, Eddie.
Challenge accepted.
Yeah. Oh, wow. All right. It's on. I would be in the Guinness Book of World Records. I would finally be rich and famous or maybe just fat and ready for a nap. Steady Eddie. P.S. Jim Ringo played center for the Packers in the 1960s. Am I right? He's right, right, guys? Yeah. Bridget says, from the 818, says, oldest living person. Breaking the record is inspiring me to get really healthy. What is the... Con, can you go to the Google? What's the record for oldest living person?
Is that that's
110 or something?
I think
like
114.
That?
114 was going to be my guess, yeah.
Wow. Okay. Like
122.
Oh, 122.
Wow. Okay.
That's a whole child away.
I am 22 right now. So that's 100 years.
100 years. Yeah.
101 if you want to break it.
I know.
Get ready. Get ready.
100, but they haven't been sexually active since they were 41. That's a long time between hayrides, folks. Jameson from Pennsylvania says, see if I'm in time. Totally made up. I breed Chihuahuas with Great Danes. You are a sick man. I breed Chihuahuas with Great Danes, and I can't stop them from making a mess after their special time. Any help?
Well, I think the biggest problem here is that maybe you just shouldn't do that.
I think if you just get some of that spray they put in the shoes, it'll just clean up anything. It'll
the bowling kill any, shoe spray?
Yeah,
I think it's a very profitable venture. I'd like to discuss this further.
Oh, you are a sick man, Jameson. That's Jameson from Pennsylvania. So the guys from Comedy City are here in De Pere. Tell us about your venue. You guys got a couple minutes left.
Yeah, our theater is located in historic downtown West De Pere.
Beautiful.
West side of the bridge there. We have been there, I think, 5 years now in that particular location. It's a very intimate theater. We have capacity for about 70 seats. So there's never a bad seat. You see the stage right there. Doors usually open half hour before the shows. We have a bar at the venue, so you can get your drinks, popcorn, candy. So you can make a whole night of it. And we're actually right next door to another bar that's a great place to go after the show, the Porch, if you haven't been there. So it's downtown De Pere is actually phenomenal for dinner and entertainment, if you beautiful. Let it be.
That's great. Do you guys have, when I did stand-up in the 90s, it was never as bad as people said, but every once in a while you get a heckler. Do you have that same problem doing improv? Are there people like that?
Yeah, and I think they're a different kind of heckler. Usually our hecklers are people who got drunk and really confident. And either they just keep trying to force their suggestions in and everyone's just like, oh my gosh, this is so uncomfortable. or you ignore them and then they take it personally.
Yo.
So then they try to like be louder and even more inappropriate. So usually the way that we deal with them is, direct the attention elsewhere and then they settle down. But in some cases they don't. So you just literally just call them out on it and you make them the joke.
Yeah.
And probably like stand-up guys would do as well, make them the joke and they'll decide to be quiet or leave. And every once in a while, that's what someone chooses to do. They're just like, I'm going to leave.
Yeah.
I feel like they'd be better, like just because there's more of you on stage, like whereas a stand-up is up there flying solo.
Yeah.
You guys are probably a little more, not intimidating, but like they'd be more hesitant to heckle.
Yeah. It's not often, but it does happen from time to time.
Okay. That's good. Well, one last plug for the holiday shows. Let people know and where they can find out more information and get some tickets.
Yeah, check us out at comedycity.fun. We are also Comedy City Theater on Facebook. So much fun stuff coming up. If you like Hallmark movies, we've got Snowy Mittens. This weekend, we've got, for Widow's Weekend, we have an all-women show, Hilarious, 8:30 Saturday night. There's so much going on. I'm not even going to list it off. There's something for everyone, including New Year's Eve. We do 3 shows on New Year's Eve. We do simulated countdowns for the family show at 5 and the adult show at 7:30. So if you can't stay up that late, we'll take care of you.
Is there ever nudity?
No.
Okay.
Not yet, unless someone really
Only once, I think. Only once.
Conrad wanted me to ask, so I just thought I would. You guys are great. Thank you so much. It was great having you in the studio. And Jameson checks in and he says, haha, thanks. Just wanted to throw a curveball. Well, your problem was answered there, Jameson. Thank you for the text. Thank you all for the texts and the calls. And thank you guys for being here tonight. This was really fun. And thank you to Yao. That was fun, Conrad.
Yeah, I can't wait to try some of that peanut
brittle. I know. I thought it was like mocklet, and it's totally opposite. It's like a real candy that's real natural.
Nothing can be as bad as mocklet, as Monica says.
Take your word for it. Will you guys come back sometime? This was really fun.
Oh, yeah.
I would love to have you guys back on the show, and we can you can get up, move around. Is it physical? Do you ever get like crazy physical on stage?
Oh, yeah.
Is it mostly? Yeah.
Yeah, there are nights where I regret not being more physically fit.
our previous location had a hole in the wall that one of our performers got a little too excited, and he just knocked into it and broke it, and then after they patched it, he broke it again. Yeah.
We will sacrifice our bodies for you if you come see us. Yes.
Thus the new venue. All right. Thank you guys for being here. This was great, and it was great to meet you guys. That's Nick Wallander, Nick Hendel, and Scott Rumat. Thanks so much, and thank you to everybody. We'll be back again tomorrow night to do this show on a Friday, a bar band Friday night, and filmmaker Cole Sheldon will be here too. This is Pete Schwaba and Nite Lite on behalf of the lovable producer Conrad. Good night, Wisconsin.
Mama made, we're making out, oh yeah, oh yeah. I'll take you to your best friend's. the national news cycle never stops. But it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.